Okay, so we're here today at Rozafa Castle, and we're going to take a walk around and see what it's all about. It's pretty gorgeous. It's windy today, so this is one of those things I'm still learning to get great audio even on windy days, but I'm not sure today I'm going to nail that. So we're going to do the best job we can, and we're going to show you the castle and the surroundings. So when you first get to Rozafa Castle, you want to buy a ticket. It's 400 lek, so pretty good, less than $4 American. And I took a taxi to get here from downtown Shkodër, about 10 bucks, a little pricey, but touristy kind of thing. Beats walking the 3-4 kilometers, so pretty good. But once you get here, again, pay your toll and just head through the gate and onward to the castle. I'm Greg, I'm your host of This Old Castle, and today we're going to explore the Rozafa Castle outside of Shkodër. Come on in. First impression is it's creepy as fuck. Thank you. Okay, so we're in the first courtyard, which had a little bit of everything, I guess. Some residents, some areas to store water, food, and a watchtower, which I assume is this. Yeah, I'd say you can pretty much see anybody coming from here, so good job by them. You also see the lake and the rivers. So, you know, military standpoint, I don't know that much, but it seems reasonable. A high vantage point, it's built near water and food right next door, so I'm sure all that played a part in their decision to, you know, build on this location. You know, this is the first time I've actually been anywhere where there's actually something thousands of years old. 53 years on Earth, first time. And in this case, you know, it's 4,000 years old in its oldest part, the Rozafa Castle. And it's neat, just knowing that, you know, this stuff isn't roped off. You can just come here and climb all over it. I've been climbing on it for a couple hours now, and it's really neat. You know, it's thousands of years ago, somebody woke up, had breakfast, and went to work. And standing in exactly the same spot I'm standing now, just, you know, started building a wall. And now I'm here and looking at it. That's the neat part about getting out and seeing stuff like this. Okay, so the second courtyard, not much left of it, but it was used for, I guess, different store areas and storage and water holding areas and access to a prison. That sort of thing, so not much to it left, but you get the idea. So the castle is surrounded by the Buna and the Drill rivers, I think they're called. And I'll show you out the window here, if you will. But here's another case where, you know, no safety rails, just drop dead if you want. Crazy, crazy place. So this is the third courtyard, and I'll read what it says. It says, the third courtyard, known as the Citadel, is smaller and occupies in the upper part of the hill. Inside the castle are preserved ruins which belong to a round tower, to a storefront, and to a three-floor Venetian building. Pretty cool. Go inside. Yeah, this is creepy as fuck. You know, one thing Albania is definitely different than the United States is safety. So here's a pair of steps that just lead to fucking death. Ugh, I don't like heights. Time to go down. So this is the cult object of the castle, and I'll read what it says. This building represents one of the most important monuments in Shkodër Castle, or Rozafa Castle. It's located at the highest point of the hill near the northwest premier of the wall, and a medieval church was built on the earliest structures in the 13th century. The interior of the church has been decorated with frescoes. A medieval cemetery is located to the west and south of the church. And later it was transformed into a mosque. So let's go take a look inside. You know, Rozafa Castle, also known as Shkodër Castle, but Rozafa Castle got its name in a very interesting, weird kind of, legend, I guess. And it goes something like this. Once upon a time, three brothers were building this. And every time they built the foundation, went to bed, they woke up and the foundation fell down. So they came across this wise man who said the reason the foundation was not strong was because they have not yet entombed a live woman in the walls of the foundation. And the three brothers made a pact that they wouldn't tell their wives, but they were going to put their wives in the wall. And they all agreed, for the purpose of the castle, let's do it. And they all went on their way, expecting the next day that when their wives all came and brought food to the work site, the castle, they'd, I guess, throw them in the wall and entomb them. Two of the brothers, I guess, loved their wives. They told them what was going on, and the next day they didn't bring them the food. The youngest of the brothers kept the secret and spent, I guess, an evening with his wife, Rozafa, and their young child, son. So the next day, Rozafa goes to the castle, the job site, with food. And the husband says, hey, here's what's going to happen. We gotta bury you in here. We got to build this castle. So we're going to entomb you in the wall. And the good sport Rozafa was, she's like, yeah, but I got like one request. Just one? Let me have it, right? And the request was that when they build the wall, they leave the right side of her open, right? The right eye, the right breast, the right hand, the right foot. The reason she wanted this was so that when their son acted up or needed a mother, she'd be there to comfort her with her eyes, her hand, nourish him with her breast, and rock him to sleep with her foot. Very nice. They agreed, and I'm not sure what to take away from that story other than Rozafa needs to be a little more assertive with herself. The relationship had no boundaries between Rozafa and her husband, clearly. But, as they say, that's the legend of Rozafa's castle. Okay, well, that's going to do it for our time at Rozafa Castle. Hope you enjoyed the walking tour, a little walk and talk with some music, kind of seeing some sights maybe you haven't seen before. I know I enjoyed walking around, good exercise and great sights. So until next time, hit the subscribe button if that's a thing you do. I'm going to be posting videos more and more as we travel further into Albania. So I hope to see you around.